We're into the next show. This show is all about freedom. Yeah, so freedom, what on earth does that mean? I don't think we understand that today.
No, and I think the problem is it's like become this cry for the modern age, because the idea that people had in the modern age is like, oh, there's like tradition and church and God who are all trying to take our freedom away. So we want freedom from God, tradition, church. And then in Milton's famous poem, Paradise Lost and Things, in it, Satan is like, feels that he's not got freedom because God's like taking his freedom away. So like when Milton wrote that, he thought Satan was a bad person, but in the modern age after Milton, they think Satan is the hero who's a freedom fighter to get freedom away because God's like taking our freedom off us. And they kind of believe, modern people read Milton's poem and go, Satan's the freedom fighter, he's the good guy who's trying to get freedom. So that's one idea of freedom that's been dominant.
It's almost the idea that anything that has any boundary, people don't like boundaries at all. But we all know boundaries are helpful. But like, for example, getting married, I've heard so many people say, oh, I don't need to get married. Anyway, when you get married, that's the end of it.
Yeah, but like, get tied down, they call it.
Tied down.
Don't they?
Tied down.
Ball and chain, and getting tied down. But it is a freedom, isn't it? It's a freedom. And I think there's that notion that people always think freedom is freedom from. But, like, in a way, the Bible, should
freedom.
We go there?
The other way, the other way.
Freedom to do something.
Hold on to that. We will come back to that.
Oh, man, that's too big of a thought.
It's freedom to hold on to that. That's totally different
to how people
think. Today, it's like, I want freedom from constraints, from anything that holds me back.
Even my own body.
Yeah.
Where people, because I remember literally listening to some, like, sociologists about 15 years ago, and they were saying, one of the problems is our human body is a very definite limit.
This is
who I am. This is it. And they were saying, because there's such a sort of longing for total freedom with no boundaries at all, they said, maybe there's going to come a time where people are not going to accept any limitations, even the limitations of their own body about their gender, sexuality, everything. And at the time, I remember listening to this chat show 15 years ago, and someone said, oh, that would be wild, wouldn't it, if people had no... And then I'm saying, it's only like 50 years on. That's like normal. Nobody wants to accept the limits, even of their own body. And it's like, but I think as well, because that notion that, you know, any... like the idea, like the classic analogy is like, imagine a train. Is a train limited because it goes on tracks?
Actually, it's very helpful. Yeah. I was on a train yesterday that got me from the south of England to London.
Yeah, and the last thing you want to do is not be on tracks.
I really want that train to stay on the tracks.
And because it's on these tracks, you say, well, it's completely fixed. And it's totally limiting it. And I'm like, it means it can go like we were in Worthing.
Well, like a car. You just hope every part of the car engine sort of works. And
And it's like, you have to stay on the road. And if you don't,
I want to go down the other side of the road.
No, don't do that. Because that's that concept, isn't it? And that when I was in Worthing, we managed to get like a train back to London for just a little bit over an hour because the train was on these tracks, which enable it to go really quickly and smoothly and things.
Kantike, we actually saw, we think, sadly, was a fatal accident just the other day as we were driving. Yeah. Why? Why was that fatal accident? The car had swerved into oncoming traffic he must have gone through a red light. And we saw that, but that's because someone took freedom totally.
Yeah, so I don't want and that's
I'm free to go.
And red people do that. Speed limits and things and say, no, I don't want any of the restrictions. And you go, well, okay, that's a kind of freedom, but one, it takes freedom from other people.
Yes.
And it's a very short-sighted thing, isn't it? Because it limits, the reason we can use our roads so efficiently, for example, is that everybody says, let's do things the same way. And that enables a different kind of freedom, isn't it? Where you're saying, okay, we limit ourselves in some ways, but that enables us to do things. Yeah. And I think that's...
I find it fascinating that everyone thinks, for example, example, people, like you said earlier, let's get away totally from religious freedom, from church freedom. But they also lump a lot of religions together.
Oh, yeah.
But interestingly, even really non-religious, or you hear a lot of people saying, I'm spiritual, don't really know what that means. And they actually really hone their bodies to fit into a certain spiritual way, be it a exercise that they do or a meditation that they do. And that, in some sense, they're trying to find a freedom within their mind and what they're doing with their bodies. But they're actually really limiting their bodies to get to that ultimate freedom, whatever it is they're looking for. And so, but they don't want any formal religion. And then they lump us all together as if all religions bring the suppression. I find that fascinating.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Yeah. And when you think, what were the very first words spoken to human beings?
You are free.
Did you know that?
Yeah, the very first words in the Bible that were spoken to human beings. You are free.
You are free.
Yeah. Isn't that amazing? You are free, he says. It's right there at the very beginning of the Bible. You're free, he says. Yeah. As if to say, look, here's the whole creation. Get on with it.
And
enjoy
what are
it.
You free to do? Dominate the earth.
Yeah.
Get to know
Use
the earth.
It.
Rule the earth. Love the earth. Cherish the earth. Nurture the earth.
Yeah, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's gardening, isn't it? That's what he set us up to do in the first few chapters of the Bible. We're meant to be gardeners.
Yeah.
And that is about, like, you know, pruning and, you know, like setting up boundaries of what grows here, what grows there. And so it is about restrictions and boundaries and everything. Yeah. But it allows each one to flourish in the end more. Yeah. Like, you know, I mean, everyone knows, like, with a vine, if you see, like, a wild vine, like, you see Tarzan going across or whatever.
I love Tarzan.
Yeah, it is a good film and everything. But you can see, like, when they're not, don't have the structure and they're just one thing on their own, they're, like, feeble things. Or if you see them on the ground and they're just a lump. But then you see, like, a vineyard and there's all the, you know, everything pulling it up and it's been pruned properly and it's been, hasn't just been allowed to grow the way it would.
People forget how important gardeners are. A lot of people, especially in the Western world, for example, love their wine.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they probably haven't even thought through the process of how that all happens,
how
they
structure.
Get that. Yeah. How much structure it took to to grow a vine, to even get this beautiful wine. People forget that.
Yeah.
And the time,
the effort.
And the cultivating of those vines, that took time, and there was a certain way to do it, and it was skilled. Mm. That is boundaries. And then that gives us the freedom, that blesses us. We enjoy the wine, the produce that's from that.
And it's a great example of that kind of concept of freedom. Again, as someone I was talking with, they said, oh, I like to see myself as living a jazz lifestyle, which they meant by that, I do whatever I want, whenever I want, and I'm just playing it all by. And I said, hang on. And then we've got this fantastic a really old vinyl LP of these jazz recordings from, like, I don't know, the 1930s or something. It's amazing. And on it explains these famous jazz musicians. And it says, like, there's this one guy, I forget his name, but they recorded this at like 5 o'clock in the morning, this vinyl, after been playing all night, and they just decided, let's just record something. Yeah. And they explained that every time when he'd finish doing the nightclub thing, he'd spend 3 hours playing classical music. Because he was training himself very, very strictly how to play this piano, and then there was his friend with a trumpet, and they would spend 3 hours just doing incredibly structured, disciplined classical music so that they'd have the freedom to play whatever they wanted. So to get to that ability to be able to play the instrument and have total freedom to play anything on it required 3 hours incredibly confined,
fantastic,
structured discipline. And I was like, oh, that's such a good example.
Well, how many of us know, in order to, say, pass your exams or get a qualification, it takes a whole lot of limitations.
It does.
It does, but that's the thing. People don't like structure.
Hold on to that thought, because we will carry this on into the next part of this series. See you soon.